Maayong adlaw sa tanan and welcome to another episode of our hashtag Be Inspired series where we have conversations with inspiring people because I believe every person has a story to share with the world. Our guest for today is currently an associate professor at Reed College of Education, Appalachian State University, North Carolina, United States of America. Maayong adlaw and thank you for joining us here today, Dr. Vicente Hanta. So how has life been lately naman, sir?
Okay, mayong adlaw man, Raymond. Thank you for inviting me. Life is so good. Life is kind. It has been mga 2 years na kami diri sa August. So it was a struggle at first, but now everything is good. This semester, this is the first time that I have no new preparation. I teach the undergraduates here. Dito medyo may tutay siyang alain when I was at the West Visayas State University. Kaya before, I used to teach mostly masters and doctoral students. Pero diri, syempre, I started ang amon yung program sa science education basically is in the undergraduate, particularly in preparing prospective elementary science teachers of North Carolina. And so, it's been good. We're enjoying our life here. So many things to enjoy. We are so blessed for this opportunity. And we are very glad that life so far, so good for all of us here.
Yes, sir. I can definitely see that sa imong mga Facebook posts that you are enjoying not just North Carolina, but maybe the United States in general. Ayan. So let's go back a little naman, sir. When you were still a kid, where did you grow up at and how was it like?
Well, I was born and raised in Barangay Santo Tomas, Pasig City. Okay, specifically sa city of Patima. Dira gid ako nagdako when I grow up and I have consciousness na mga namuklatan ko bala dira sa Fatima. We have a very nice neighborhood, mga pamilya namon, sa ako niya mother, father's side especially, Tiara Manda. The neighbors were good. It's a nice place. Spent of time to enjoy nature. Sa una yung mahampang niya, kasimple lang. At the back of our house, may suba. Tapos sa atubangan, you can see a lot of rice fields in there. Sa una sang gamay ako. So damo gid ja opportunities to enjoy life nga daw wala pressure. Hambal sa nanay ko pigado kuno kami, pero when I look back, ako to hindi man gid pigado kay I honestly the childhood was so enjoyable. Wala pressure sa kabuhi. Tapos nag-enjoy ka lang bala sa palibot mo and then I had plenty of exposures to the natural environment, suba, talamnan, you know. Yeah, sa unang Santo Tomas, yeah, ang bukid na buta pa na sa mga kahoy da. So, nagpangahoy pa na kami sa una. So, my childhood was really a very good, happy childhood, no? Kaya it so happened, ako ang last niya, how would I say? Ako ang pinakaagot sa mga So na medyo, at least daw, na-spare gid ako masyado sa mga farm work compared sa mga mga akon ginikanan.
Yes, sir. So speaking about your parents, sir, what's the life reminder that they always tell you or remind you about maybe life or about anything in general?
Yun ang nagtatak lang na permis sa pinsar ko. Kahit ang nanay ko at grade 5, nabalo na si nanay mo napatay ng ako niya father. So ang ginapound niya per me sa mind ko, which I'm happy that I followed her. Mali yan ang eskwela ka maayo, magmatutong ka, trabaho lang sa maayo. And then, alam mo na itutong ka, hindi kita pigado kita iya, so dapat magmatutong ikaw. Tapos kung magdako ka na, hindi ka magbisyo. Hindi ka magpalayo ka sa mga inom, palayo ka sa mga drugs, palayo ka sa mga bisyo, focus ka lang sa imo pag-school. And I think it was a good son that time. So, sunod din ang akong nanay, no? Ginsunod ko gid siya, and I really studied very hard, worked hard. Nag-struggle gid ako. Astang nalabot ko kung anong mga gusto ko sa kabuhi. No? So that's life's greatest lesson. Yes. That my mother used to tell me, trabaho ko sa maayo, magmatuto, mag-eskwila, kaya mo lang ginatsansa mo, makatibawas kita sa mga buhay. Ano? Yes. And I followed her, and I think she's really very right, was right.
Yes, sir, for sure. Yan, so like your parents is proud of you from what you've achieved this time. And of course, sa mga apo, for sure, sa mga kabataan mo, sir, I have seen that they are achieving things on their own naman. They are performing very well. Ayan. So how about for elementary, high school, and college naman, sir? So where did you study at? And how was it like, maybe a memory that you can recall about your elementary, high school, or college days?
So sa elementary ako, dira ako nag-eskwela sa una Santo Tomas Elementary School pa ina. And later on, it became F.J. Santibanez Memorial Elementary School. So dira ako nag-graduate sa elementary ko, and I'm very high on top of our class. We had great teachers in there, great memories sa eskwelahan niya na nag-provide sa ako niya. Elementary basic education. And then 2 years I studied at Pasay National High School. And then another 2 years, nagsailo ako sa Iloilo City National High School. Kaya ako niya sister, pala nag-work, used to work at TSWD in Molo. So since pigado ang ako niya nanay, so dito ako nagstay sa ILAS na natapos ako sa high school. At Iloilo City National High School. So my greatest achievement there is that at least I graduated sa Lutotorian at City High. It's a very big school. So unaya wala pa mga extension schools dira. And then after that, nagkato ako, nag-eskwela ako sa West Visayas State University, where I got my Bachelor of Secondary Education, major in General Science. And I graduated in there in 1991.
Wow, ay pakahop na bata. Sir, 1992 ako, so ay pa ako na bata. Okay, so...
Yung magali ay.
Yes, sir. So
and
how about...
You're achieving. You're reaching heights and yeah.
Malayo pa ang umaga for me.
Yeah,
I still have a lot to learn pa. There are so many things I have to learn, I guess. So,
yeah.
Yan. So, sang elementary ikaw, sir, or sang high school ikaw, napinsaran mo doon nga like gusto mo magmingin teacher, science teacher, kag I know very good man ikaw sa math. Si Vince is very good sa math gid. Very, very good. Ayan. So, what made you decide to take up science, sir? Secondary education major in science.
Okay, honestly, sang gamay pa kuya, grabe ang ako niya ng handom Raymond. Kay balaan mo, ang gusto ko yata niya ng field, medical doctor. Di ano kay ginatampa, kasang kamatuuran. Bale magnay mo. Ako man na later on, nag-consider, nag-decide, so I was telling my mother, ang bakunay, gusto ko tanya mo na ako. So, ugaling kay, tibalaan mo, hindi mo siya kasarang walaan. Yes. Ang pinakamayo nga, makaubra ko dayon, makabuling sa pamilya. And then close man sa medical. Pero mo nang major ako sa science, kaya ito tamba ko, sige ha, sa lepis ko lahawan ko akon kaugalingon, only to learn later, nga wala man niya night school galing sa medicine. So that's why, nag-education ako, kaya I concede to my mother's idea nga, hindi kita kasarang, which I agree. I analyze it. I look at the situation. Bisan education gani. I survive through scholarships. Kag ambulang na ang mga courses nga may mga scholarships balaan.
Yes.
So wala ko option. Actually, wala ko choice. It's the only pathway. I have no other choice, and I embrace it. Din-embrace ko siya kay amuna ang akon niya nga dalan niya pwede maagyan at the moment. Pero looking back, learn through the years what the work of an educator is, most especially that I'm in the business of teaching, preparing prospective teachers. So I look back, so my goodness, this is a great career, great choice, fulfillment-wise, variety of experience, personal growth, opportunities for advancement, lalo na kung sa university ka, damo ka options, damo ka choices, pwede ka research, pwede ka extension activities, may mga service activities ikaw, and in my case, because I said I survived through scholarships, I studied at UP Diliman for my master's, and I majored there in chemistry education through, again, scholarship, and then eventually, I got my PhD in the United States of America. So may mga ano siya, may mga, how would you say it? May mga time na hindi ka na lang puro teaching lang when I start to teach niya. So may mga professional advances, and along with those are opportunities to travel, opportunities to learn new culture, new place. And those are things that have enriched me in ways that I did not imagine as a child. Growing up in Santo Tomas, no, yes. I really thought that teaching is something like will pigeonhole you there. You start in there as teacher and then you retire. But yeah, there's so many opportunities if you are teachers now. Okay, and I said, oh my God, thank you so much. Thank you for bringing me to this field and looking at the impact of this profession of mine to the future and to other people, and it's a source of joy, and it's a source of inspiration. My students have taught me a lot of lessons about life, about themselves, about people, about adjustment. Many of them I learned from my students, most especially when I came here in the US and started anew here. So I'm learning a lot from my students through the years. And I'm very thankful for them, for the richness of their ideas and their persons that have enriched me as well, because I am in a profession that requires me to interact with people, most especially with younger generations who eventually will become leaders, probably, or become teachers on their own in the field. So the question was, that's my story of how I become a teacher. It's not actually my first choice, but the second choice is better, I think. It's better. Because it led me this far.
Yeah, definitely, sir. You've mentioned, sir, that you also took an interdisciplinary qualitative studies and a PhD in science education from the University of Georgia. So during your stay at the University of Georgia in the U.S., what are your realizations naman so far, if you can recall during that time?
I have to think about 10 really realizations. Kasi syempre, who am I to study in the U.S. on a Fulbright scholarship, which is a very competitive scholarship sa Philippines. Kaya all fields nag-apply dira. And I was one of the, and it was a Fulbright classic, a degree program that that enabled me to study here in the US. Realizations during that time in the present. Mamuna balanga, in the past, you have less choices. Dutay lang choice ko, wala ako choice ng una masyado because of the limitations of my parents. Pero eventually, as sige ka lang persevere, go on, eventually the roads will be widened and you will have plenty of options. And so, it's a great opportunity for me na ma-expand ko ang akong understanding about the field, ang ako na expertise sa linya ko gidya kay sa science education ako from undergraduate to master's to PhD, and on top of that I had a graduate certificate in qualitative research. So medyo paama lang siya, but it so happened that when I took qualitative research subjects at the University of Georgia, we have options if you would like to go into quantitative, if you want to go into qualitative, pwede ka kapili. So kung mag-quali ka ng linyada, you have to take a minimum of 3 subjects. A 4. three one quantitative and three qualitative research subjects. But in my case, I think I took six because I was so in love with in love with qualitative research at the time. After I took one subject on its philosophy, on the epistemology and theory behind research, I said, there's something new. Kaya dito nataka naman ako sa kwanti sa una, sa Philippines, Pilipinas pa ako kasi undergraduate and master's na muna ng classes na research during the our time. So that's why when I learned the philosophy about it and what kind of new knowledge it can offer, na attract ako sa idea, this is what my country needs, this is what my university needs. So I dig deeper about it. And so intertwining with science education, I specialize on the anthropology and sociology of science education, which brought me into research that delves into the interplay of science and culture, how to indigenize the curriculum, how to make culture-based education, how to hybridize the curriculum, how to contextualize, how to consider students' backgrounds and community forms of knowledge when you teach them science education. And that's connected how I come to NCCA.
Yes.
So damong ganyan yung learning opportunities. Nagasakripisyo kita in one way, pero on the other one, nag-gain man kita because I had a family during that time. So mga things nga daw, mga sacrifices, not just my sacrifices, but probably the sacrifices also sa akong mga kabataan, ang mga kakulangan ko sa ila. Pero kung sumahon mo tanan, damo gidaog. We have won in many battles in many areas that could get ang benefit because of that decision to advance ourselves. Because we're not thinking of ourselves alone, myself alone. My decisions are meant for the family, it meant for the university, it meant for the country, and those are things that probably the conviction that for probably the Fulbright Commission in the Philippines or PAEF was able to see in me why, among many others who applied for the program, I was one of the chosen few and was given the opportunity to study in America.
So you also mentioned earlier, sir, about completing a cross-cultural research on the indigenization and hybridization of the science curriculum in Thailand and Japan, and also included some trips in Cambodia, Myanmar, Laos, Indonesia, Taiwan, and US. So somehow, what are the things that you've learned, sir, from your trips or from your research?
So in 2011, I got the opportunity to study the indigenization and hybridization of science curriculum in Thailand and Japan. That is through the Asian Public Intellectual Fellowships sponsored by the Nippon Foundation of Japan. So for 6 months, I did research on how culture play in the education of science students in Thailand, most especially in their elementary schools, and also in Japan. Siyempre ka namin, you know, from the US to the Philippines, and you go to another country, you know, Thailand, although Southeast Asia man siya. Pero when you go to another country, you learn not just the field that you specialize, but you also see it from the broader perspective of the culture of the country. So that's why it really opens a lot of your understanding, most especially like me, who have this insatiable appetite of like knowing others, knowing culture. I like to travel a lot because it is easier to learn. I mean, naka-enjoy ka gid ko mag-travel ka balaan kay nagapaniyati nga ka. So damo ko gid sa mga balaan, dagko na higop mo na balaan nga. So kadamo gid ako sa balaan sa Thailand, paano sila mag-indigenize ang nila curriculum, paano ilang nga language, kay they speak Thai, kita ato niya ya. May local language pa kita ginag-rapple, may national language pa, may English pa. Okay, I learned about the curriculum, I learned about the laws, and I went to like travel different places, and almost half of Thailand from Bangkok up to the northeast, And I learned about the Isan culture to the north. I learned about the Lana culture in there in Chiang Mai, Chiang Rai, Chiang Dai. And in the north also, I had the opportunity to travel with some faculty members at Kasetsart University, one of my host institutions in there. And we crossed Laos and Myanmar. Laos and Myanmar, no, dito sa ibabaw gali, tawag nila nga triangle. And so nagsakay kami sa Baruto, nga dira sa Mekong River nga na, sa tunga-tunga da, sa imo nga piyak na side Laos, sa piyak na side Myanmar, sa tubangan mo Thailand. And so we search, my goodness, amunin gali na sa triangle, no? And so we cross Laos, explored a little bit, and then know a little bit about Laos. I went to Myanmar on the other side, explore it also a little bit. So when I was in the Northeast, sa isa naman, sa Mahasarakham, Rajabhat Mahasarakham University, so my colleagues that I work with there, they exposed me to the Isan culture. And then we had a side trip to Cambodia. During that time, Angkor Wat, on this, and many things that we traveled in there, and what it brought me, what did it bring me? New experience, new level of understanding, new perspective. Kadamo ka sa may mga kaino-ino when you are exposed to a lot of culture, hindi ka stereotype. Hindi ka na pigeonhole. I mean, the mutual understanding ang ginatawag bala. Maintindihan mo ang iba niya perspective. That's very important, I think, for a person in the academe. Yung makagrow with indigenization, so hybridization. So that's why timing yan nakasulod ako sa NCCA. So I brought learn from Thailand, Japan as well. The ideas about indigenization and hybridization, mga designs on we plan for our projects in there, na-influence man sa akong niya API fellowship. And in fact, kung nakasulod ako sa NCCA, kay one of the fellows, kati tatlo man lang kami sa two during that time, was connected with NCCA. Vic, di ba ang research mo sa ganito, indigenization, we will be going to the Visayas, we'll be holding the Cultural Education Forum in there. Pwede ka mag-speaker and talk about what you did in Thailand. And that's my first exposure sa NCC, and they like it a lot, that eventually, gitan pala, Diyos Amun, join Diyos Amun. So, amun mo lang itong ako niya first exposure, and then eventually, slowly, I joined with them in their cultural education activities, and then after that, I became part of their committee. So, mula ako niya story, ang connection sa API fellowship ko, ito nga ako niya NCCA experience and connected as well to my UJA Fulbright and qualitative research experience and my dissertation as well.
So, timely and relevant lang, sir, ang mga things nga nagkatabo kag na-experience mo.
Nag-expand lang, nag-expand kabalaan kung ang taon mo ka-analyze mo. Nag-connect siya. Naganami kay nang galapad pagid nya nang galapad pero ara ka man gyapon sa imo nga core. Ang akong core is science teacher education, studying, expand ka sa cultural education, expand ka sa how to do research on cultural studies in science education. So wala ka man nagapalayo, actually ginalapad ya lang ang imong dalan. And that's the beauty when you travel. That's the beauty when you expand yourself. You know what I mean? So, so nag-graduate ako sa West Visayas State University. So nag-eskwela ako sa UP Diliman for my chemistry education. Dito man ako yun naka-realize, ay, maupod mo sa wing. Sa APL pa ako sa una nag-stay in a dormitory. Ibut ko lang pag-graduate nila sa Japan na sila. Nag-PhD. Or sa Korea, or sa iban sa Europe. And so, ayun, pwede gali. You know, you get the inspiration. Nagalapad, nananawan mo ang vision mo, nagpalapad mo, nag-expand isang imo nga education kay kang imong experience, dira ka makita nga ay may ara pagid yali. You thought you crossed already one mountain, but up there you still see more mountains ahead of you. So muna ang lessons balaan nga, pero wala man ko gyapon madula sa akon yung core. You know what I mean? In-reach niya lang ako. In-expand niya lang ako. Pero actually, I'm still there. And everything is connected. Daw wala bala na, tawag mo, daw nakahon siya. No, it's not. Everything is interconnected. And when you make meanings out of it, you can see that, it's a big mosaic of a beautiful story and experience.
Yes, sir. So I think that's the beauty of traveling, sir. I know you don't only have the chance to discover the country that you're visiting, but you also get the chance of discovering yourself and discovering your country and maybe somehow appreciating your own culture in a way. So how many countries have you visited so far, sir? Maybe there are 8, like I counted on my list here, 8 or 9 or 10 maybe. How many and what's like the country that you're looking forward to visiting in the future?
Okay. So let's say, of course, we're Pilipinas. Kita, Indonesia. Nakatumala ko sa Indonesia sa una. And then I went to Taiwan. I went to Thailand, Laos, Cambodia, Myanmar. Of course, United States, Japan. So far, kita umuman, ano pa nga ako niya nalipatan? Umuman lang na, no? And mga dream countries ko, kamukamu pa. I want to go to Europe. I want to see what Europe is. I want to see the old world. The U.S. is a new world. But, you know, having learned about the history of education, the philosophy of education, the seat of the Western civilization, the role of Roman Empire, and the Greek history. Oh, I want to see Europe. Antes ako mag-eskwela, mag-silo diri 2 years ago, I had already actually a visa. Makato ako tani sa Europe. May research preparation para may professional development activity ako in preparation of our project and it's a Pilipinas. Ready na. Pero looking at it, short term versus a long term engagement. So I think this is a better way. Actually, wala ko gid man naging strategize magbalik dili Raymond. Wala gid. Nag-dawn lang na sa akong balaan at the age of 52, January, hambang ko, dalang taba mo ang mga opportunities ara man sa akong available kaya having graduated in the US, I know where the opportunities are, where are the websites. Kinalantaw ko malang mana sila. Pero wala mo bala ginaplanong maglakat git. Kaya first and foremost, ang akong service obligation first and most universities of us is 13 years. No? Wow. So, gina-entertain ang other staff. Akong yung service, return back to the country and the university, things that they have given me. Pero at the age of 52, ang bal ko ay, nang now or never. May opportunities. Now or never. Kahit kung magtigulang ako, laban-laban, hindi naging kakudiriya kakadto. And I said, hindi ko mamabalaan kung may chance ako, hindi ako mag-try. Yes, right?
Definitely.
Because the first step, if you have to do some kind of action, akong tulutisting lang tani, eh parang wala man ko regret sa ulihi sa kabuhi. Balang naman ba ako, tingin, try mo, at least hindi na para sa iyo. So that's why when I tried it and I got it, so that means it's for me. Para bala sa akong bala, kahit di. So tuod lang daw kuhan lang siya, natawag mo bala nga daw, ulan niya nagtulo sa itong kabuhi, again, grab mo right away. And then, for all you know, all of a sudden, it becomes yours, no?
Yes, sir.
Because you are ready, you have prepared yourself to be here. That's an important thing when you prepare. Wala ka balo ka anong mabot. So, preparado ka lang. Kung ano opportunities, ara siya, you grab it. parable of the 10 virgins wala sa Bible. Tawag, no? Ang preparado, yeah, ready to go anytime. Pero ikaw, yeah, may opportunity to prepare ako pa sa imo ka.
Yes.
I think handa. I'm always handa. So,
yeah, I like that sentence.
True to my family name.
Yeah. So you mentioned this earlier, sir. You were the Commissioner for Cultural Dissemination for the National Commission for Culture and the Arts in the Philippines. So what are the things that you liked about this job naman, sir?
Ay, tingin namin, dira ako naman na-learn. Kaya ba ko sa imo, di ba, nag-specialize ako sa akong research on the anthropology and sociology of education. So you study sense education from the lens of culture and society. And so, the platform, kaya ato nga na nakahon ang mga agencies, taya mo. So that's why dira ako nakasulod. Kaya dahang committee sa national committees at NCCA. And one of those committees is on cultural education. The rest, yeah, is like theater or like dance or like music, okay, architecture and something. Pero ti akon kay hindi man ko ya artist. Educator ako, pero at least ang ginaobra ko mga research sa cultural education within science education. So nakaswak ako man sa ila bali. And eventually nakasulod ako sa national committee, and then eventually ay 6 years kita na ako niya stand sa NCCA. My last term was already something more on sa ibabaw na, because I was elected as the chair of the National Committee on Cultural Education my last term. Then eventually na-elect ako from among the committee heads, yung mga heads ng cultural dissemination section. And then once makuha mo na automatic, you have a seat in the Board of Commissioners of NCCA. Oo, muna ang nakasulod ako dira. So ang na-learn ko naman, it's a top-level positions for the country. Basically, ang trabaho dira is policy making, making decisions. You plan for the cultural education of the country. Wow. You plan for the programs and projects. There is money from the government. It's a taxpayer's money. How do you plan that? So ara ka bala sa position on deciding what would be, it's a big responsibility, right?
Yes.
You sit in the committee and you decide what project would be funded, what would be the sinutagaan sang kwarta para ma-push ang cultural education advocacy sa country, plan for the activities. So you learn a lot. You learn the politics behind it. You learn other naman sa ibabaw, paano mag-play up, paano ang decisions. Actually, ako kapulupanilag how decisions are made. How, what's the political side of it? Honestly, when I was growing up in schools, wala akong kuma-expose kit sa mga leadership position. Okay? Matutom lang ako, no? Pero eventually, by virtue of your education, an opportunity is given to you whether you like it or not. You'll become a leader later on, because that's what you get when you advance yourself, no? You become a leader. So I learn how paano, ano nung nakalatabo, and I also decide based on my convictions. So kadamo ko sa na-learn about the Filipino society, about the culture and the arts sector, about what other committees are and how we play in ano ang among role, most especially for the advancement of culture and the arts in the Philippines. So kaya nami lang, like for example, natagaan mo ako opportunity magpungko through NCCA is a technical teacher education council, and there I meet umandira ang mga heads ang mga agencies bala. So daw ka surreal ng mga experience nga when I look back at them, balko kanami lang bala panong demonyo, at least you have so many experiences to draw from and make meaning.
So, how long have you been teaching na ba, sir? Like 27 or 28 years? And what are like your best memories or kind of like realizations maybe being a teacher?
I taught for about 30 years.
Oh, wow. yes,
and 27 years of those years were spent at the West Visayas State University.
Oh, wow.
So, ang akong hinurusgan, ang akong, the best of my life, my youth, was spent in the teaching career, was spent at the West Visayas State University. So, kung magbalikid ako, so, ang dali yung ginahata ko sa mga estudyante ko, katiting na lang na sa serbisyo ang nahata ko na sa una.
Yes.
Okay, I think I serve the country, I serve the university. So that's why, yeah, it's been a 30 long years of service to the students, to the Filipino people, to the different agencies, particularly in the academic agencies of the country. Mm-hmm. And those are things that gives me some sense of feeling mo palang, yeah, you got out of the country, but wala ka hinulsol, wala ka man sang nagasukma sa imo nga kaugalingon, hambal ka, nangalit ka lang, wala. Mm-hmm. Kahit nag-issue gid ako, iba niya gani, nailis ko ilan, dito wala nagabalalik sa ilan. Wala ko, yaya, hindi ko gita siguro ma... So ako yung nagserbisyo gita ko gintapos sa mga service obligations ko, and the best of my youth and the best of my ideas were poured out there. Base ang environment ko was not just ready for my ideas, but in all honesty, I could always say that the best of myself and my ideas were given out. So kung sa inuman to, mga estudyante ko, mga naka-eskwela under sa akon, who are leaders today or in the future, you have the opportunity to expand and extend what I have taught you. Diba? Kaya nahatag ko na sa inyo ang mga ideas ko. To the point, yung nakamba, I was so dried up. There's nothing new anymore. Wala na. Kahit amutuhan mo ko, ay, daw sa plato na ako sa akong career there sa Pilipinas, what more can I give? Actually, wala na, kahit nahatag ko na, may feeling ako, I was so dried out already. Everything was like everything was like daw ka-routine na. Dugay ka na, tutukad ka sa class mo. 5 minutes before the class, lang daw ka sa silba, ang topic ko sa book. And then you go to your class without preparing. Pinatudlo mo na for 10 years. Wala na challenge. Very comfortable. Mabalo comfort zone, blood just my professor, 6 na ako dira, no, with the salary grade 29. 2016, ready na ako for a university professor, ang mga papers ko. Hulat na lang ako, dugay nga wala matap sa akon. But what I mean is, ang idea is that, yeah, comfortable na tani, eh, garip ka na lang sa ano, kahit kabalo ka naman sa Philippine government. Yung mga pasito. Relax ka na. Pagkakalawa kayo mo ni Raymond. Galing nga. Sa mo sila ng condition. Because you feel like you are dry inside.
Yes.
Ang imo person, daw na stifo.
Yeah. And
do wala growth.
Yes. Adventure.
Doon ko na ba na doon na rich sa Pilipinas. Na rich ko ang ako niya. Plato. Kaya first, nag-commissioner na ako sa NCCA. Nagpungko pa ako sa Board of Regents during that time as a faculty regent, as a faculty association president. So, ara ako sa duha ka big agencies. Nga ang ubra, puro policy making and himosang decision making. Di daw nga feeling mo ba lang na ara ka na sa peak. Kapag actually, all you have to see when you look back is pwede halong magin niya. Downhill niya nga ako.
parang daw boring.
Downhill or complacency, something like that. I don't like that, actually. Yes. Hindi ako ang musin na. Yes. I like excitement.
Adventures.
I like something new. I want new learning. And it came at the right time. And I was in that period when this opportunity to go back here to the US mm-hmm. and teach.
Yes.
So nanabuhi naman ako ng pagkatao.
Yes. Na-inspired naman ito mag-travel.
Excitement.
Yes.
So one year and a half, grabe struggle. Grabe, you have to learn a new system. Was especially the technology part in teaching. Ang technology part, sa Pilipinas, namik lang magtudlo. Namik na ginayang magtudlo. Pero sa namik ka pa magtudlo, kung hindi ka kapalusang technology, kaya ang platform subong, hindi lang classroom. May technology associated to it. May platform. Yeah. Okay, sa amin rin gagamit kami sa Azure. I have to learn it. And at my age, kapudlay mo. Kailangan ka na mag-learn sa technology, no? And then you learn about students. Lain sila. Even assessing students. Lain, yatudlo ako assessments. So I was with science for a long time. We have to learn. Grabbing a struggle. But the beauty of it is, may struggle, kag ma-overcome mo, a new level of learning. May ginatawag ikaw nga, na-elevate mo naman ang imo self, nabuhi naman ang imo pagkatao, na-reinvent mo naman ang imo self. May bago naman niya excitement, may bago nga lessons. So daw pareho ka naman sa sponge yung nag-absorb, eventually you are so full. Pwede ka naman mapuga, kaga yung ano ka naman, ma-water and the brown blood from you. And that's the beauty of it. I learned something new again. So it makes me alive again. And makes me excited every day to learn new things, explore. Kahit idre mas malapad pagkita ang kalimutan.
Yes.
And amuna ang nagapalipay man sa akon. Kaya at least in a way, nabuhi naman si Vicente Han. Wala ko nagtulok na ma-downhill na ako sininda. Wala na. Hindi na. Subong naman may new visions naman.
Yes.
May new mountains ka naman yung nakita. Yes. Another way of expanding yourself. So, age is just age.
Yeah.
What the person in you will remain young as long as you're open to new ideas and opportunities for learning. And that's the beauty of it all.
Yes, I definitely can't agree more to that, sir. Yeah. So I think that's also the beauty of traveling and exploring new places, adventures, is that somehow you discover, sir, that there's life outside the city where you live, or there's life outside the workplace in a way. So parang that's my realization then somehow. You've been traveling abroad. You are currently living in the US. So what are your hopes and aspirations naman, sir, somehow for the Philippines in a way?
Well, the best of my aspirations were already given, but I still don't give up. No, I would like to believe that my aspirations and hopes were already communicated to my students, most especially to my doctoral students, who will eventually, I think so many doctoral students have gone through me, and they've heard me, and the visions and the dreams, I think, in one way or another, were communicated to them. And yeah, I will continue to dream good for the country. Ara da ako na tao, mga pamilya ko, ara padera, to ako bataan, ara padera, no? And who knows? Sidera mong kumapuli eventually, wait, takabalo. Yes. Wow, ay takabalo. Ara ako sa point sa akong kabuhin niya. Just I allow life to, to, ining akong experience, I could consider it's a bonus in my life already. So I'm just open to whatever God will give me, whatever opportunities will give me. But as of the moment, with a lot of hopes and dreams as well. Kabay pa nga mag-ayong atong tungsod.
Yes.
Kapay pang ang itong mga teachers ma-uplift ang ilang condition, not just economically, but they will feel good about themselves. Ang itong mga tao dira makabatsag sa sense of pride about themselves, the country that they have. Proud sa ila kagalingon, proud sa ila kultura, proud sa hindi man sila nagalin. And will not just settle on that but move forward para nga ma-advance pa gid ang ato niya pungsot.
Yan, yes sir. So during my first travel abroad din ano, like I thought Iloilo or Philippines in general is already a progressive country, but when I traveled abroad, I came to realize that we're like 20 years behind, 10 years behind, or 50 years behind. So all we can do somehow is hope for a better Philippines in a way, and then a progressive Philippines, and do the things that we can do on our own, because like on my own, I cannot do a lot of things. So I'll just do what I can for the Philippines.
Ang masarangan talang.
Yes. Yes.
Ang importante nga nahatagta ang ato niya masarangan. Kaya as long ang benchmark is ang masarangan ta.
Yes.
Pagka, I always believe, wala ka good regrets in life. Looking back, the time that I spent in education, all the sacrifices that I went through, I was like a nerd when I was in high school and college because I was so focused in my studies. Amulang ni ang ako ni ang pwede ma-embrace as of the moment. Kibot ka lang later on, ano, opportunities become widened, damo sang mga possibilities in a tabo after that. So, wala, gabalik yad ako. Wala git kaya bala regrets. Nagrabira yad ako. Wala git. Mga time din pang spent ko in studying. Instead of regretting, I feel the sense of pride and fulfillment that I did my best. Wala ka na. I did not let any turn opportunities, stone of opportunities unturned. Kin-explore ko gid siya. Kin-try ko. I work on what I wanted, and so, and I give my all. So, ano pa i-regrets ko agi? wala. Kung schooling wise lang, wala ko sa mga regrets. Kaya I know I gave everything that I can possibly do during the time and on those circumstances. May ara man tayo nga falter ka, pero eventually that's the core that I lived by. And I did not regret. Nagbalik man sa akon in multiple ways that I did not imagine when I was living my life. No, nagbalik kita nan sa akon. I know my children will benefit from this. And other young generations of my family, mabalik kita ya. Kaya Biblan Raymond, hambal ko sa imo ako ang first nga generation college graduates ang family.
Oh, wow.
Ang agot. Sa ako niya mother side amuman, taga Dumar, father side ko amuman. So wala ko sang model. Kaya ang mga tao nga may edad sang sa ako, makatiyuan ko ang my elders, did not understand what I went through when I was a student because they did not experience those. You know, yes, what I mean? It's so difficult to tread a new path. Ako gid siguro ang mahambal ko na, that's a very, ang pinaka-proud ko. Sa kay nanay ko aside, ako ang first generation college grad. Sa kay tatay ko amuman. And now when I look back sa mga kapuhan, mga kay nablusan, sa kaya kay their announcement, some are achieving as well. And I would say, oh God, thank you so much. Ang dira na lang, no? For all I know, base na inspirements. Ay, lain din man niya gali ko nag-eskwela, no? At least in a way, may malantawa na sila. A little model that they know so well when I was so young. And we grow up together. And then cousins and family members when we grow up together. And they see the difference when I embrace the pathway of education. And so, makita mo, nagabira-bira na sila. Pinagigastuhan ng kabataan for education. And that's one major, how would I say, realization and achievement that probably I feel proud about myself. Yung nag-create kasang dalan that your elders did not normally pass through so that others behind me will get an inspiration and then,
achieve.
Pangita man sila sang ila dalan, pero at least may makaintindi na sa ila. May man, they know already. Sana mo na lang sinasama ko. I keep on encouraging mga bata sa mga blues ko. Come on, study. I mean, go on, Marcel. Okay, yeah.
Yan, yes, sir. So I know you are a very busy person in a way. So how do you balance work and life naman somehow?
The work ako bira-bira, Raymond. Pero sa tuod lang, kinakombine ko na sila. Like for example, kung may research ako, kita mamba ko sa Japan. Lagaw mo na ang bra ko, sige research. Present ako sa paper, present ako sa paper, attend ako one or two sessions. Lagaw, explore, what's the place? Visit the museums, visit the place. Kung mag-supervise ako sa student teachers, kung dari, gadi-tour ako pagkatapos ka observation, kag manungat, sige, ulan tao. So, always, kay something new. Nabala ang excitement to learn something new. And in addition to that, syempre, lalo na there is I really love Boone, North Carolina. It's a very beautiful place. You see mountains, and in fall, this place is like heaven. And I love mountain climbing, I love trekking, I love walking in the park, I love nature, I love the lakes, the rivers,
road trips.
I love gardening.
Oh, yes, lately, sir, I saw.
I love museum, I love national parks, I love, okay. Part of work. Itigatudlo ako environmental literacy. Itigatudlo ako nature and youth dari. So, ang ginalearn ko kag things that I like to do, makalit ang gihapon sa akong niya trabaho. So, hindi siya two separate worlds. Makombine mo ang imong gusto. So, nag-enjoy ka na.
Nag-learn
mo ang ginatudlo mo sa laparos. Ito may mga materials dari nga ka very culture based man, like Grandfather Mountain, nga kalapit man dari, pero bago ako dari, so inilanta ako mga course material. My goodness, what's this? Sa nga rin po, yun pa explore ko na ng mga lugar eh. Hindi syempre, ang connections wala. So gina-combine mo ang mga, ang trabaho, ang opportunities to enjoy para hindi ka man worn out.
Yes.
Exercise. And eventually, I go back again to my core of eating healthy food. Kaya pagaling ko, grabbing a pressure 6 months before I left. For the process of getting a job interview, ang screening process
alone,
3 months, and 3 months that I worked for our visa for all of us. Nagmalasakit ako, ang sugar ko nalaas, mag-BP ko nalalaas. Pero when I begin to adjust, balik sa healthy lifestyle, balik na sa balance ang inatawag, going back to the core, the new sense of vision. So, balik ka naman sa where your balance is.
Yes.
Okay.
And I also like your reflections, sir, sa mga posts mo lately. I really like reading your reflections. Can I make it?
Take it on Raymond.
Yes, sir. Ang
experiences na bala, mga fleeting moments mo lang. Kundi mo na iapagkwaon ang mga nuggets tira. Pag i-document, malipatan ko na. So, gambala ko sa imo. I used to say that I had a great memory. Kana grabe kita crystal clear sa mga first time nagatigbulang ako nagtala sugar ko pero bong ay wala na balik na sa normal ang memory mo affected na kamalipat so dapat you have to document them ang experience mo i-relieve mo siya and I relieve that through writing through documenting it and so a fleeting moment become permanent, no?
Yes, perfect.
Kakalipat ang mga connections, nakakalautod na sa mga utok na ito, mata-destroy through the years. Tipa mo naging man ang ako niya patulungan. So, samtang I can get wisdom, I can draw nuggets of information and something, I feel like, you know, may mga elated ka bala, yung mga aha moment ka, capture ko ina balaan, kay kanukun. I want to look back at all of this. Of course, side has its negative sides, of course. Pero kung na-document mo yung mga beautiful sides, na yung mga balikan niya sa ulihi,
Yes,
ang
sir.
kasakit yung nag-aagi man na, pero ang kalipay, kung na-document mo palaan, kaya ang wisdom dira, it's something that you could hold on. And in my old age, ano na pwede mong mapugutan sa ulihi pala?
Yes,
ay,
sir.
Ay, sinabala. Lipay ako sinabala. Ano na make a point, ako ang pwede lang. And at least, iban sila ang mga pictures yung ginasa akon lang na, pero something pala nga, I am no longer like containing them to myself. Sharing it to others. Kasi iban sila, many of these are like elevated level of experience.
Yes, sir.
It's my one way as well of sharing. Sharing this elevated moments to others, and we do not know. Hindi tayo kapakot sa mga impacts na sa iba niya.
Yes. Like me, sir.
I mean, ang impact sa ibang balaan. In sambal ka man yun. At least I have not lived my life in vain, ano? If you create positivity and positive influence to others, that's something na consider natin niya. I do not just keep it to myself. The giving of others may come in variety of ways, but at least I don't self-contain myself like the Red Sea. I keep myself like a river that flows wherever it will go. Gabiander siya. Wala kabalikin din na makadto. Pero at least you keep flowing. Ang nag-flow, wala nag-kahubsan.
I agree, sir.
Kawata, yapon mo naman. So, if so, nag-give ka, kung tagoon mo lang bala ang experience, ikaw lang na yan.
Yes.
Pero kaya kabalusang hindi na yan padulungan.
Nag-panos, sir, kung tagoon mo lang.
Pwede yung ginasya. So, kung isa, ko, mas mga baliban, mga ganyan, book ako or what. Pero this is a distillation of ideas.
Yes, sir. And I like them, sir. Please keep them coming.
Distillation bala sa ideas nga. Kung taguon mo lang, daw kalaho ay man.
Yes.
But you have obligation. Although, I have a responsibility to myself, but still, because I was given a lot by life, life was so kind to me, considering where I come from, I think it's also right time that I should give back.
Yes.
Just financially to others, but give back whatever you have.
Yeah.
Because some others, you do not know. Hindi tagidya kapakot. Education mentality, wala. You do not know the impact of your persons and your thoughts to others. Yes. It's a positive shagani.
Cool.
I-share.
Yes, sir.
Bala na ko yung mahal sa iban, pero at least, gintabri mo ang imuha o galingan to the public, most especially the positive sides of your experience to others. Yes.
So I think we're somehow down to the last three questions. Medyo chill na lang siya, sir, in a way, I think. So what advice or tip can you share to aspiring teachers who maybe in the future would want to somehow be like you, also teach abroad, or maybe as inspirational as you are?
Find your core. Find what you want to happen in your life. And on the process, always learn something new and share what you have learned. Explore other possibilities. Kung may gusto ka, put into action. Basta maayo lang ang katuyuan mo. Kung maayo mo ng hando mo, hindi ka maka-hurt sa ibang niya tao. Sige ha. Basta ano pala yung hambal ka ibang niya ni mo. Sige ha, kung banta mo sa kaugli mo, ang conviction mo ng gasili niya, I should do this. I've listened to my conviction. If I heard, sang gamay pa ko kung ginpamatian ko ang mga discouragement, siguro, but no, I listened to my conviction. Pamati ka sa imo kagalingon. I learned a lot from my mistakes. I learned how to navigate. Ang mga mistakes ko naghatag sa akin sa mga big lessons in life about people, about others, about relationships. And learning from them, you learn about life. Okay? So, ang advice ko sa mga teachers, well, our profession is a great profession. We're touching a lot of people. And if you are in that profession, our investment is with others. The children who are listening in our classrooms, we do not know their future. But through you, you can inspire them. You can pave the way for them. And you can be an instrument for their better persons. So that's our source of power. And that's a source of our strength. And so enjoy and love our profession. Eskwela ka, i-advance mo yung mga self, continue to share what you have. Damo opportunities kung teacher ka. Basta hindi mo lang pa i-close mo o galingon. I am very happy that I am in this profession. The older I get, the more that I am convinced that this path is the best path for me. Mayroon wala ako nag-doctor. Kanami sa ako niyong profession. Example, nag-tigulang ako, nag-anami pagyad ang panulo ko sa sa profession niya. Ini. Kapin pa, ikaw ko elementary teacher. Ikaw. kung nagatudlo ka sa maayo, ay sus niya. Wala pa na sila balaan ma ako niya mga estudyante ko, mga maestra halos. Pero yun mo yun, may engineer ka, may doktor ka, may lawyer ka, may ano ka na. Mag age 50 ka. So, my goodness, malibot ka lang din sa return on investment. Magkanto ka sa City Hall, magkanto ka sa NSO, dira mo nga balaan, lakad ka sa SM, na dira mo nang balaan ang return sa imong investment. Ang mugid na ang na-realize ko through the years. So for the teachers, go on.
Yes.
This is a great profession.
Yan. Sige, go on because teaching is a great profession indeed. Last two, I guess, sir. So message to your former students, your current students, maybe your friends, relatives, and families.
Naon ko ako niya family.
Yes, sir.
Ang ginahambal ko permiso ako ng mga pamilya sa mga kapuhan ko, sa mga inabuligan ko man in a way, sa mga younger generations sa amin yung family. We are not born in a privileged family. Hambal ko sa inla. Anong malang aton yung kapital? Eskwela ko mo sa maayo. If you're given the opportunity by your parents, huwag na pong supportahan yung eskwela ka mo sa maayo. Maghandong ka mo, advance yun yung self. Tutom ka mo sa inyong pa. Kahit wala man sa substitute dira. Ayaw gawa ko na born ikaw nga syandero ginikanan, but we are not. Sabi mo lang gijiya nga chance. Educate mo yung mga self kag maging mudos ka dira. Kahit amung malang na ang nabalaan ko nga formula for success unless kapamana ka o pangasawa ka sa mga magaranon yung mga tao. Pero ang chances mo balaan to have that is also very nil. Kaya yung mga socialization, hindi man sila. I mean, wala kayo mong masocialize sa ila. Wala kayo eskwila sa big private school where the rich are studying. So, ang chances mo kayo, ang na-available lang sa imo is the pathway of education so far. And I went through that pathway. So it's not easier to convince them. So I'm very happy mga kapuhan, libra-birawan sila. Ano man sila, sigihan nyo da sa mga kabataan kong I'm very happy of their achievements. I'm very happy of their success. At least they imbibe also the love of education that I have. And ang pagka-independent ko daw, nakuha pang kuha Manila to the point niya, hindi na ko gani. They make their own decisions. And okay. Kaya ko sa unang hindi mo na kumintran. Oh, sige, basta. Kung ano yung gusto, basta sa kayuhan, go on. Mga kabataan ko, tanana sila yung pa-influence ko, medical doctor, mag-go into medicine. And nobody wanted that. And I always tell myself, it's okay because that's me. And they are also different. So lain mo na sila, yeah, may ilaman silang handom. I don't want to make them an extension of what I dream. Yung wala akong makuha. Diba? Hindi mo na dapat. So, I support them. And I'm always praying for their success and their eventual place in their design. Kung diin man sila yatapuktukan sa ilang kapalaran, I'm very sure na, of course, I always pray that God will bless them in all their endeavors. Sa akong mga estudyante, dira, I think, kidahamot na gid sa nag-go through sa akong life. And many of those students I have, 27 years in teacher education, are now teachers in the field. So, and so many I saw on Facebook are the leaders in the field. So you have a big task before you. Our country, ang ato niya pungsod gidya, kinanglan gid sa inyong service. So that you are now the extensions of my hopes and dreams. And once you are placed in the position of power and privilege, please make use of those to help others and to help our country and to help our society. What else? And to my friends and mentors, thank you so much. I could not be here without the help of others as well. Mentors have supported me through the years, teachers who educated me, my elementary teachers in Santo Tomas who inspired me a lot in many ways, my love of literature and reading actually started off in Santo Tomas. Kaya mga namin namun iyang mga teachers ang una sa mga reading, kag sa mga ano. So that's why nagpalabasa ako because of them. Kaya nag-intertwine ang love ko for the literature. Kaya my teachers were so good during our time. So that's why nagsunto ako sa chemistry education because my high school chemistry teacher inspired me. She was a very good teacher. Nagkato ako sa cultural studies and science education because my major professor was an expert in that field. And I was inspired by them. So everything that I have are results of a lot of people, my parents, my family, the love of my brothers and sisters, and my family, my parents especially. So I'm always thankful for all of them. My, teachers, mentors, colleagues.
Yes. Okay, I think this is the last one, sir. Maraming last. Okay, so what's your ultimate motto or guiding principle in life that somehow you always remind yourself?
Well, gihapon humbal ko sa imo, himakas ka lang niya. Wala gid regrets kung ginahatag mo imong best in life. Continue working. At the same time, you enjoy life. Give as much as you can. And at the same time, learn from the experience. And always move forward. Move forward, you could bear me. Kahit ang bako sa imo, kalaw ay isang comfort zone. Kadedening siya man lang. So, I always seek that. Don't settle lang sa comfort as the basis of life. Ang mga tutay niya, mga tensions, mga difficulties, once you overcome them, it gives you a new meaning and a new vision in life. And so, take life as it is. Enjoy, work for your dreams. Hindi lang tamang tapak sa isang katao. Lagi na malain. And be kind as much as possible. Ayun ang balang termi sa ako, no? Lagi malain ka, mag-kind ikaw. Ano? So, gina-remind na ako niya sa isang sa mga estudyante kong gisa nga. And I'm nag-ni-fail, pero yung best overcome it actually sa mga decisions kong ang kindness, kit pero may kapag-ibag chances. Ano gitong makuha ko? Wala. Wala ka gitong kwaon. Pero sige lang, Pwede wala taman kabalo sa mga circumstances ang ilang kapuhiwalaan. So kung pwede ka makahatag, patience mo, kung something yung kapagbulig sa isang katawo mo, I try to do that as much as I can. Okay.
Yes, sir. Ayan. So I think that's all for me, sir. Madamo, gid nyo salamat for joining me today, for sharing about your life story, for sparing some time to talk to us today, and for us to get to know you a little more.
Okay. Thank you man also, Raymond,
yes,
for the opportunity. Dudugay na niyang bal mo sa akin.
Yes, finally. Thank
Dugay
you.
Na niyang
message, yes.
But I was not ready. I was adjusting. I have so many things to do.
This is the perfect time.
Among it ang perfect time.
Yes, yes.
Na-overcome ko ng mga struggles. Point of, I see new realities, new meanings. So I think this is the right time to share. As I said, something good, something beautiful, something encouraging. Share and be inspired.
Yes.
Kalawa ay mag-share kung ara ka pa sa struggle ng moment.
Laing video pag-share kung maliwalas.
Maliwalas.
Yes.
Ready. And what you share is something beautiful.
No. I can't agree more.
Wala na pangit, wala na pain.
Yes.
Muna ang beauty that.
Okay, yes, sir. Thank you once again, sir. I think my takeaway from talking to you today, I'm really looking forward to talking to you because you are an inspiration, not just for me, but for everyone else. Is that like you've mentioned earlier about opportunities for teachers? Kasi like sometimes you have this notion, ay, diado na ako sa barangay namun, diado lang ako ma-retire until the end of time. But like we have to discover opportunities for us, that there's life outside the place where we live. And then, of course, you've mentioned also, sir, that you'll never know unless you try. That's also my mindset when I was on my Fulbright, because I applied to Fulbright DAI. I did not qualify, but I tried again. No regrets, no what ifs in life. Ayan. So cheers to more travels in the future, Sir Vic. And I am looking forward to seeing your Europe escapade.
Among it ang ultimate niya travel.
Yes, sir.
South America.
Yes.
Damo pa ko sang gusto nga explore actually. Yes. Help the time will come.
Yeah, for sure, definitely. Kasi like from the US, medyo lapit lang siya in a way, or there are many flights available. So, madamo gid nga salamat, sir. Enjoy the rest of your day and thank you once again. Arigato
gozaimasu. You're welcome. You're welcome, Raymond. Good morning there and good night here.
Yes.
Bye-bye.
Salamat, sir. Ayan.